Well, as the title states, how do you clean your RC car? Well, this is how I do it. Man, that's dark. Let me turn on my actual shop lights. Woof. There we go. Have you ever had shop lights that are so bright they actually blind your eyes? Yes, there's paper towels on there as to diffuse the light. Anyway, I do a 50-50 mix of Simple Green and water. You can buy this wherever they sell it. Usually grocery stores, Walmart, hardware stores, maybe the local bathhouse next to the, you know, the all-Asian, all-night tug massage place. You know, sometimes you gotta get crazy and clean that shit up, you know what I mean? Anyway, I mix up a 50-50 mix, and I put it in a squirt bottle. I'll show you what I do. Now, you may see inside of my tub, it's all greasy and gross and full of black shit. Well, that's because I've cleaned my RC cars in my bathtub. And that's what I'm doing here as well. Basically, the main thing is I just take this Simple Green mix and just cover everything. Sorry about the sniffling sinus sound. What can I say? It's cold. It's Michigan. And it's gross out. But at least I don't have the coof. I just have the gross. So I hope this is in focus. I'm trying to roll my eyes up into the back of my head so I can stare at my, or so I can see what's going on in my camera screen. So anyway, and then to get down here in the junk where it's all gross. I see I use a lot more soap when I'm looking in the camera to see what I'm doing. Alright, so I usually do this for mud or if I'm getting into something really nasty, dog shit, something like that. I mean, and let's face it, guys, anytime you run, oh, there goes my bottle. Anytime you run an RC car, you run the chance of running into dog shit. And when you hit dog shit, it just ruins your day. So anyway, we're going to let this sit for, I usually let it sit anywhere between 5, 10, 15 minutes. You know, it depends. Drink a beer or something, you know. Or if you're one of those weed guys, you know, when you sober up, you know, let it sit. Don't let it sit too long, though, because the soap will get sticky. So, all right, I'll see you in a minute. All right, well, in my world, it's been, oh, shit, I don't know, about 10 minutes. We're going to fire up some hot water. And this is why I do it in the bathtub. Because I got one of these power shower heads, you know. The one you don't want your old lady to fuck with. Because then she's like, I don't need you anymore. Yeah, we all know about that. It really is just this simple. Hot water works better for obvious reasons. Ugh. Man, this thing is still fucking heavy. But obviously hot water works best for, well, breaks up grime. And because the water is hotter, it dries faster. Which is going to take me to my next step that I'll explain. Let's say you're a dude that doesn't have any way to dry your car. What do you do? Well, I'll explain it. Give me a second. So ordinarily to dry this thing out, I bust out the air compressor and blow it all off and let it sit. I'm sorry about the scum in my bathtub. I have well water. What can I say? That is not butt sweat. It's not nut oil. It's good old-fashioned rust. So, see, it's clean up here where the water doesn't run. I guess it doesn't really help. But anyway, yeah, my shower head, or my tub head broke off. Trailer park life, yo. So, anyway, it's been like that since I moved in. I don't really care. So, fuck it. Anyway, Just let the thing sit. Let it sit for, a day or so. Obviously, it would be better if you had an air compressor, because then you could just blow everything off and blow it dry, and it's all nice and happy. But I don't, which is part of the reason why I like stainless steels. Well, I have an air compressor, but I'm not going to do that in this video. But let it sit. Let it sit like this for, half hour or so, and then take it and flip it 90 degrees. Let it sit 45 minutes to an hour. Flip it another 90 degrees. Let it sit. Flip it another 90. Let it sit. And the reason that is because all the water runs down, gravity and all. And then when you take it and rotate it 90 degrees, the water runs off that way too. So that's what I used to do before I had an air compressor. Then, when it's all dry and nice, I don't recommend doing this in your bathtub. But, you can if you want. Once it's all dry, WD-40 everything. Spray everything down. I don't do my tires, but I do everything else. All the plastics, all the metal, the aluminum. I have a windshield and stuff on my Baja, so I wouldn't recommend that, but because it just makes it greasy and disgusting. So in this case, I would take the roll cage off and hose everything down with WD-40 and let it sit. Even better if you could let it sit in the sun, because then that WD-40 just soaks into your plastics, makes your plastics a little more forgivable, a little more flexible, and everybody's happy. But if you have an air compressor, blow it dry, hit it with WD-40, let it sit 10-15 minutes, blow it off again, throw it on the shelf, and you're done. But if you don't have an air compressor, it might take a day. You can spray WD-40 in your bathtub if you want to, but I will tell you, it's going to turn it into a slip and slide. Which, you just sprayed WD-40 in your bathtub, so it's not that big of a deal to you. But if you live with somebody, you might want to let them know. Nothing worse than here. Wah! And she falls down and slams through the fucking side of the, the bathtub, or slams her fucking hips in the toilet or some shit, because you forgot to tell her you WD-40'd the tub for it, just that way it wouldn't rust. Because plastic tubs, they rust. Ask me how I know about this. Not the plastic tub, the WD-40 part. So, anyway, this is what I do. And don't worry about that. You don't need to worry about that. That's just scum. It's scum queen. I don't know. It's a plastic fucking tub, man. I live in a trailer. Cut me some slack. I don't have any money. Look at that. Non-monetized channel. Come on. Why didn't you hit subscribe already? What's wrong with you? Help me out, man. I need some cash. Click subscribe. Click the like button. Don't make me come to your house and choke you like this. But anyway, that's how I clean my shit. And part of the joys of living in Michigan is every time you run your shit in the snow, this is pretty much what you have to do. Because, if there's more than 3 snowflakes that have hit the ground, the salt trucks are out there. That's why my 2000 Chevy pickup with 120,000 miles is half rusted out. Because every time more than 2 snowflakes hit the ground, they're out there with the salt. And it just makes everything rust. Bastards. All right, I hope this helps. How to clean your RC car. This works for all scales. It's definitely a lot easier if you have something like a little Tamiya 10 scale. You can clean those in the sink. And then it doesn't matter if you WD-40 the sink, because the old lady probably ain't going to stand in the sink. Who am I to judge? Maybe you guys get kinky. I don't know. Cool. Hey, good for you. Anyhow, why haven't you subscribed yet? Click that like button, damn it. I put these up for you. Have a good one, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.